मैं आप सभी के बीच में राकेश खन्ना जी का स्वागत करता हूं, पंकज जी का स्वागत करता हूं और तमाम साथी जो यहां पर हैं उनका भी स्वागत करता हूं दोबारा। ये एक मार्मिक लड़ाई है सर, हिंदुस्तान का नहीं सारा वर्ल्ड में सबसे पढ़ा लिखा तबका जो अपनी सारी जिंदगी दे दी, सारी मिडनाइट ऑयल उसने बर्न किया अपने डिग्रीज के लिए, देव ऑल द डिग्रीज, देव द बेस्ट परसेंटेज फ्रॉम दिस कंट्री फ्रॉम अब्रॉड, दे फुलफिल ऑल द क्वालिफिकेशन नॉर्म्स एज हैज बीन प्रिस्क्राइब्ड बाय द यूजीसी, मच मोर देन दैट, दे हैव बीन अपॉइंटेड थ्रू ड्यूली कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड सिलेक्शन कमिटीज एज हैज बीन प्रिस्क्राइब्ड बाय द यूनिवर्सिटीज गाइडलाइंस, ईसी गाइडलाइंस, एंड विच इज ऑल्सो गॉट अप्रूव्ड फ्रॉम द यूजीसी ऑल्सो। They teach against substantive vacancies. The 200-pointed roster is at place. The SCST observer, subject experts, everybody sit in the selection committee as has been mandated by the EC resolution. So what I am trying to say, this is a properly mandated constitution selection committee that my friends have gone through. But they are subjected to harassment after 4 months. They are being tortured. There is a great sense of uncertainty whether they will be continued or not. Every time they have to feel the heat of the things, they have to please everybody. It's a torture. And can a teacher who is not free can do justice to his students? And if this becomes the state of affairs, all these people have come from a panel prepared by every department for which 2 times a year they seek applications. And I will request those friends, those who are not unmuted, kindly mute themselves because there is lots of sound. So this is the greatest tragedy that is happening to the most talented people, not only of this country, but of the whole world. Almost 5,000 teachers are being treated like slaves, academic slaves, year after year. And we know if there will be a selection committee, as Himanshu was rightly pointing out, 90% of the teachers will be shown the door. 90% will be told that you do not have a place where you are teaching. What is their fault? What is their crime? And why good people will come to this profession? Now, we know some people have betrayed our movement in the past. In order to defend the vice chancellor, in order to defend the government, but we have learned from our mistake. Our resolve is as strong as it was earlier. Many teachers have been, aap log keh rahe the ki koi teacher ko hata nahi rahe hain. Samlal College mein pregnant women was removed. Dolatram College mein ek SC teacher belonging to the scheduled caste, she has all the degrees, she is one of the finest teacher, she is articulate, she is a product of this university, she was removed. What was the reason? No reason was offered. At Lakshmibai College, who is doing all these things? If you do not stand together, then tomorrow each one of us will be targeted. So let us stand together. We have 2 very eminent persons from the legal domain. Without any loss of time, I will request Rakesh Khanna ji to kindly take it over, and I request him to kindly speak on the subject, sir. Mr. Rakesh Khanna, सीनियर एडवोकेट एंड फॉर्मर प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द सुप्रीम कोर्ट बार एसोसिएशन एंड फॉर्मर एडिशनल सॉलिसिटर जनरल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया.
थैंक यू आदित्य जी. आदित्य जी, पंकज जी, रेखा दयाल जी, डॉक्टर सर्वेंद्र कुमार, आलोक रंजन पांडे जी एंड ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम द टीचिंग कम्युनिटी ऑफ दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी. In any society, one has to measure the progress of the society. It is often said that how the society is treating its mentors, the teachers, is the measure to see how the society has progressed. I myself had been a student of the Delhi University, but when I see today the situation in Delhi University becoming alarming, it really pains me. As of today, I am given to understand there are more than 5,000 assistant professors and teachers in Delhi University who are working on ad hoc basis in various colleges and departments of Delhi University. This social and job insecurity and sword hanging on the careers, livelihood, and prospects of these ad hoc teachers is perhaps unbearable for all of you who are working on ad hoc basis. As I understand, since 2010, there is no major drive in the Delhi University for regularization of the ad hoc teachers or appointment of permanent teachers. Resultantly, there are large number of ad hoc teachers who are working for more than 10 to 15 years. With the implementation of OBC reservation in the higher education by the central government, the number of vacancies have been increased in the Delhi University, but unfortunately, no corresponding recruitment drives or regularization of ad hoc teachers drive has been undertaken by Delhi University. It pains more when one of the best universities in India, that is Delhi University, is facing an unprecedented, abnormal situation where more than 50% of the teachers' sanctioned strength is manned by ad hoc teachers, and there are large number of vacancies even today. The UGC norms permit only 10% of the ad hoc teachers, that is looking at the leave vacancies or maternity leaves, etc., which are for short periods. As per the Delhi University norms, the ad hoc appointment is supposed to be made for 4 months, whereafter either they should be regularized or regular appointments should be made. Let us understand who are we, who are these ad hoc teachers. These ad hoc teachers have been appointed by the various Delhi University colleges and departments by duly constituted selection committees as per the norms laid down by the Executive Council of the Delhi University. All these teachers have requisite qualifications prescribed by the UGC, like UGC NET, GRF, MPhil, PhD, postdoctorates from the various renowned universities in India and abroad. All these teachers have been appointed after these posts have been duly advertised. All these teachers are working against substantive vacancies, and their appointments have been approved by the governing bodies of the respective colleges and under due intimation to the Delhi University. These 5,000 teachers who are working for over 10 to 15 years in the Delhi University are therefore facing not only uncertainty for themselves, but also for the students who are not sure that after 4 months, whether that they will be having a teacher in the classroom to teach them or not. Even otherwise, looking from legal aspects, these teachers who have been appointed for 4 months and after a gap of 1 day, reappointed for last over 10 to 15 years, cannot be said to be working on ad hoc basis. They are working continuously. Their capabilities cannot be questioned. Their qualifications are, as I said, meeting all the norms of the Delhi University as well as the UGC. So the question arises, what should be the solution? When this problem was discussed in Delhi High Court, long back, if I remember correctly, somewhere in 2010, I appeared for a matter. Justice Bhadardurej MS bench passed a direction directing the Delhi University to immediately fill up 4,500 vacancies, which are manned by the ad hoc teachers. But unfortunately, after 10 years, the position is the same, which was in the year 2010, when the Delhi High Court directed the Delhi University to fill up these posts. When duly qualified teachers are manning these posts, after a due selection by a duly constituted selection committee, what in law can be the courts to settle the careers of these ad hoc teachers? The issue has been deliberated by the Honorable Supreme Court in many cases. And Constitution Bench of the Supreme Court, in the case of Uma Devi, far back in 2006, 5-judge bench has laid down that the government should avoid keeping employees on ad hoc basis for long terms. The court goes on to say that the solution to the problem can be by bringing in one-time regularization scheme. As I understand, even in Delhi University, this one-time regularization scheme was brought in the year 1979-80, 87-88, and 98-99, and then again in 2003 by way of temporary ordinance, which is 13A, Ordinance 13A of the Delhi University. I think it is high time now for the authorities in the Delhi University and the Executive Council to take a positive decision, settling the careers of these 4,500 or 5,000 teachers working on ad hoc basis in Delhi University for no fault of theirs, by bringing in an ordinance regularizing the services of these ad hoc teachers working for these long many years. The recently also Supreme Court in the case of Shiv Narayan versus State of UP in 2018, speaking through my Lord Justice Arun Mishra and Ellen Rao, Justice Ellen Rao, has re-emphasized the need for the governments to give regularization to temporary employees as the ad hocism not only affects the employee and its career and its livelihood, but also affects the work culture. The solution, therefore, according to me, will be to bring in an ordinance and regularize the services of all these ad hoc teachers who are working for long many number of years in Delhi University on ad hoc basis. This course not only has been adopted by the Delhi University itself, but has also been adopted by the Rajasthan government by absorbing thousands of teachers in 2008, and then again in 2010 by regularizing the services of 28,000 para teachers. Similar recourse has been undertaken in the West Bengal, where about 7,000 guest college teacher services were regularized in 2010. Similar situation has arisen in Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, and Haryana governments. And these governments also had undertaken these one-time regularization schemes and regularized lakhs of teachers working in those states. Most recently, the Punjab government had regularized the services of 37,000 employees by making these ad hoc employees regular. Not only this, even the Delhi government had announced regularization of almost 70,000 employees, including over 15,000 teachers working on contract basis. So in my submission, in my view and my suggestion, your movement should be for demanding the government to bring in one-time regularization scheme or ordinance and regularize the services of all these teachers. Let me look at this aspect from another angle. In our constitution, under Article 21, a right to livelihood has been recognized as a right to life. Far back by the Supreme Court in Olga Tellis case, the position has been reiterated by the Supreme Court in Ketanov cases, where the Honorable Supreme Court has repeatedly re-emphasized that right to life includes right to livelihood. And it is the duty of the governments to provide right to livelihoods to its citizens. The situation today is that these ad hoc teachers who are working for long many number of years, who are deprived of their not only the basic emoluments, but also many other benefits like maternity benefit, their promotional aspects, career enhancement prospects, etc., etc. The moment these teachers are regularized, not only their livelihood will be secured, but also I believe that a sense of certainty will come in the academic atmosphere of the Delhi University, leading to further improvement of its academic achievements and re-establishing Delhi University as the best university of India and abroad. With these words, I end by once again suggesting that the emphasis of the movement should be directed towards demanding bringing in of an ordinance to regularize all the ad hoc teachers who are working for number of years as a one-time regularization scheme, as has been done by Delhi government, Punjab government, Rajasthan government, UP government, Haryana government, and so many other governments. Thank you. Thank you very much.
We practically do not have words to explain our gratitude. You have taken time from your busy schedule and your thoughtful and insightful and articulate presentation has given us a new way of understanding the things, and you are an authority of law, and you have already helped the teaching community while appearing in defense of 500 teachers. Those appointments were under question. You successfully ensured their continuance. Now we will be, in the coming times, we look forward to your kind help and assistance in this regard also, sir.
I'll be available any help which is required to the teaching community. I'm available 24/7 for your cause.
Thank you, sir. Such a busy person and a renowned lawyer of the country. Right now, then I will request to play another short video.